Damn it!
Ah, this game is hard, but I really want to see the ending. Wait a minute, I'm a developer. I can enslave, make a bot to play the game for me, and I totally know how to do that. So after some deep learning more than I ever did in my school, here's what we need. First, a screen sharing software. I found this free and open source software called Scrigby. Oh, I mean that's obvious. And now we can see and control my phone through my PC. Then we need to pick a suitable programming language. And what's better than Python, it has libraries that have the tools we need. Plus, I'm pretty good at it actually. For those who don't know, libraries are like packages of functions and classes that's been done by nerds that can be used by such myself. We need four features: detecting pixels on screen and pressing on screen buttons using the mouse. We can download those libraries using PIP command in CMD. And now we are ready. Oh, and by the way, the game is called Sprint RPG. I wanted to provide a link of the game, but for some reason it's been deleted. Man, whatever I touch just gets ruined. Finally, we need to know how to make the bot win the game. Luckily, the game itself shows us the correct button to press, so all we need is to detect pixels in the buttons, and when they are highlighted, the bot should click. So using the BuyAutoGUI library, I can check the position and the color of a pixel, and take notes of what I need. So if I followed everything correctly, this should work. And I got an error. Classic. Let's just hope this is an easy fix. So, it wasn't an easy error, but finally we're clear. Now let's try the bot. Okay, I think I should Hey, yo! Dang. Oh my god, did you see that? It worked, that was amazing! So I tweaked some values here and there, and it's ready. At first it looked like it's working fine, but later for some reason it kept making mistakes. It looks like it's pressing the button twice. I didn't really know why, but I guess it's because of my spaghetti code. So I threw that away and activated to Pro Coder mode. I learned this technique from an Indian master in the Ever YouTube mountains. So after making some weird changes, I tested the bot on a mid speed just to check, and it worked perfectly. I decided to start the game with this speed since whenever I speed it up, it gets errors. The game has 15 levels, I start from level 1 until it loses, and then I'll figure a solution. So yeah, it started and I just watched. Yeah, the first level, easy. Next. Cool, then I just let the bot continue, level by level. The bot did a good job and survived until level 8. Now I need a way to speed up the bot. And since more speed makes the bot go crazy, I thought maybe the problem isn't with my code, but the mirroring application. Fortunately enough, this was an easy fix. All I had to do is to increase the amount of data being sent per second. And voila, this should be enough to speed up the bot. I increased the speed and let the bot continue from level 9, and it won. The same goes for level 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. And finally level 15, which is where I kept losing, but the bot was failing again. And again. And again. I was about to give up, but my dad once said, "Don't ever quit or I'll beat your ass." What a great father. Unlike your drunk dad. Anyways, I kept trying until... Come on, come on. Oh my god, the boss! Come on, Charlie, you can do this! Hell yeah! Finally, I cured my curiosity. Oh wow! Well done, the crown is yours. It is too big to fit through the door, so it'll have to stay down here and guard it. Forever. Okay, thanks, I think. Well, what now? I was thinking about making another bot for another game, maybe like Elden Ring or Clash Royale. But yeah, I'm too lazy. So why don't you check this video and be a cool guy and smash the like button. See ya!